Hello students, myself Nitika Dharmoli, teacher at Mother Asindhya Public School, and today we'll be continuing with chapter 2 of class 6 science part 3. So far we have discussed what are nutrients, nutrition, components of food, importance of dietary fibers or roughage and water. Today we are going to start with a new topic, that is balanced diet. Now let's see what is a balanced diet. The food we take every day like dal, chapati, rice, curd, vegetables, fruits and milk is called our diet. And we need all the nutrients, water and dietary fibers to keep our body active and healthy. Now see the diet which contains all the nutrients in correct proportion, in right proportion, is called a balanced diet. See the pyramid of the balanced diet I have shown over here. So the diet which contains all the nutrients in correct proportion will be considered as balanced diet. And the balanced diet may vary from person to person depending upon the gender, age group and living style. It provides sufficient amount of energy to our body. It provides materials for repair of damaged cells and tissues. It provides materials for growth and reproduction. So a balanced diet for a normal and healthy person should contain carbohydrates 60%, fats 15%, proteins 25%, small amounts of vitamins and minerals. Also, for a growing child and a pregnant woman and a nursing mother, there will be a need of more proteins. So see, the balanced diet is varying over here. Similarly, in case of sports person or a laborer, they need more energy for the physical work. So their diet should be rich in more carbohydrates and fats. Then let's take another example. An ill person requires more vitamins and minerals to fight against diseases. So hence, he needs more fruits and vegetables. So almost all the food items contain two or more than two nutrients, but only one of these nutrients is more abundant in one food item. See, milk is a complete food and it contains all the nutrients needed by our body except only one, that is vitamin C. It is not there in milk. Then pulses are rich in proteins. Carbohydrates and cereals also contain both these nutrients. Therefore, they make bulk of our diet, pulses and cereals. Then sprouts of moong, black gram, etc. are rich in proteins, carbohydrates and vitamins. So we must take sprouts in our diet. Then daily intake of dal, rice, chapati, green vegetables, and a little of jaggery provides complete nourishment. So this will be a balanced diet. Now see the next topic, deficiency diseases. So before moving ahead, first understand the meaning of deficiency. Deficiency means lack or shortage of nutrients. When this shortage of nutrients is there in our diet, this causes this shows some deficiency symptoms in our body, which are called nutritional disorders or deficiency diseases. These deficiency diseases can be discussed under the following four heads: protein malnutrition, protein energy malnutrition, vitamin deficiency diseases, and mineral deficiency diseases. One more thing, people do not suffer from fat deficiency. Why? Because excess of carbohydrates and protein is converted into fat for storage. Now, the first one is protein malnutrition or kwashiorkor. Protein malnutrition, the deficiency of protein causes protein malnutrition. Now, see what is malnutrition? The condition occurring in a person were not getting enough of the nutrients. And in the protein malnutrition case, the condition arises in children of 1 to 5 years of age when there is a deficiency of protein in their diet. If they do not get a sufficient diet or sufficient amount of mother's milk. Symptoms are children suffering from kwashiorkor show stunted growth, large pot-like belly, that is stomach swollen, then mental retardation, swollen face, thin legs and cracked and scaly skin. You can see the picture over here. This child is suffering from kwashiorkor. Now next, protein energy malnutrition, PEM, that is the deficiency disease marasmus. Now see what happens in marasmus. It is a disease caused due to the shortage of protein as well as carbohydrates in the diet of children. Symptoms are children suffering from marasmus are very thin and weak with loose folds of skin. In such children, growth of body stops and the tissues are slowly destroyed. See the picture over here. After this, vitamins, deficiency diseases and symptoms. Vitamin A, deficiency diseases, night blindness symptoms, dryness of eyes, skin, improper vision and dim light. Then vitamin B1, deficiency disease, beriberi, inflammation of nerves and speech difficulty. These are the symptoms. Then vitamin B2, skin disorders, deficiency disease and symptoms are inflammation of tongue, irritation of eyes and poor growth. Then vitamin B6 causes anemia. The deficiency of vitamin B6 causes anemia, convulsions in infants. Symptoms are yellowish skin and weakness. Then deficiency of vitamin B9 causes anemia, general weakness, soreness of tongue, cracking corners of mouth. Then vitamin B12 deficiency causes perinaceous anemia. Perinaceous anemia is a severe form of anemia. This causes because of the insufficiency of vitamin B12. The symptoms are loss of appetite and stamina, frequent headaches. Then vitamin C deficiency causes scurvy, spongy and bleeding gums, increased susceptibility to infections, pain in limbs. Then vitamin D deficiency causes rickets. Symptoms are soft and weak bones, deformed bones and joints, softening of ribs, arched limbs. Then vitamin E deficiency causes reproductive order disorders. The symptoms are damage of red blood cells, loss of muscles, slow blood clotting. Then vitamin K deficiency causes excessive bleeding, that is hemorrhage. Symptoms are slow blood clotting. Now see mineral deficiency diseases and their symptoms. First of all, calcium. Calcium deficiency causes rickets in children, just like vitamin D deficiency causes rickets. Similarly, calcium deficiency causes also rickets in children and osteoporosis in adults. Let's see the image over here. Here, rickets in children and osteoporosis in adults has been shown in the diagram. This diagram is showing the osteoporosis. See, in normal person, the bone density, then the reduced bone mass with the age, and 40 years of age, the density, the bone mass is this. Then in 60 years of age, the bone density or bone mass is this. And in 70 years, osteoporosis, the bone density becomes so less. And then this diagram is showing rickets in normal person legs and rickets. So calcium deficiency causes rickets in children and osteoporosis in adults. Symptoms are poor growth of bones and teeth, weak and fragile bones. Then phosphorus deficiency causes rickets, poor bones and teeth formation, loss of weight. Then iron deficiency causes anemia, paleness of nails and face, low hemoglobin, fatigue, and loss of weight. Then iodine deficiency causes goiter, enlargement of thyroid gland. Goiter is uncommon in people living in coastal regions because they take seafood which is rich in iodine. But people living in mountains often suffer from iodine deficiency and develop goiter. Now see sodium and potassium, hypokalemia, dehydration, extreme muscle weakness. Then fluorine deficiency causes tooth decay, defective enamel of teeth. These are the symptoms. Then zinc deficiency causes anorexia, hair loss, white spots on finger nails. After this, the next topic is undernutrition, malnutrition, and obesity. First of all, see undernutrition. When body gets less amount of nutrients, undernutrition means body is getting less amount of nutrients than the requirement. This unhealthy state of the body is called undernutrition. Undernutrition may be due to the following reasons: because of poverty or non-availability of sufficient food due to drought or other natural calamities. So undernutrition, you all have understood, the body is getting less amount of nutrient than the requirement. That is called undernutrition. Then malnutrition. In malnutrition, the food is lacking or it has a shortage of one or more than one nutrient. It is due to the intake of unbalanced diet. See, protein malnutrition results in a disease called kwashiorkor, which we have discussed just now. Then protein and carbohydrate malnutrition results in the another disease called marasmus. This we have also discussed. Now, a malnourished child does not need costly medicines or tonics. He should be given the required amount of balanced diet. Even the government of India has started many programs to combat undernutrition in pregnant women and nursing mothers. Also, the government of India has started a midday meal program for school children. It has been started all over the country to provide balanced diet to poor, undernourished or malnourished children. Look at the picture over here, children eating midday meal in a government school. Now, the next is obesity. Obesity, it is a condition. It arises when eating energy-rich food in excess, means more than needed by the body. When intake of energy-rich food more than needed by the body, this condition causes fat deposition in the body and leads to obesity. Obese persons are prone to so many diseases like heart disease and high blood pressure, increased level of cholesterol in blood, then diabetes. Now see the causes of obesity in children. Obesity in children has become a common problem these days. This is due to excessive intake of junk food like pizzas, burgers, potatoes, wafers, noodles, ice cream, soft drinks, etc. And the other reason may be instead of playing outdoor games, playing games on computer and watching TV for long hours. These are some other causes of obesity. The chapter has ended now. I hope you all have understood the chapter, and this was a very good learning experience for you all. I'm hoping the same. Now I have few questions for you people. See the questions. Take a screenshot of these questions. Try to solve them. Thank you for watching the video.